Hey guys, on today's tutorial we're going to be looking at my top 5 free music apps. And we're going to start with SongSound and Spotify. Those two are pretty similar, that's why I'm going to compare those two first. So these are apps that if you go into them, for example, they're more like a radio. So if you know what you want to hear, for example in genres, you can go to country and then you can just tap on this first one. You might get a commercial first and then it's going to start playing the song. It's going to play one after the other. So you can just skip if you don't like that one, but you can only do that up to 5 or 6 times, and then it's gonna tell you they can no longer skip for the next 15 minutes or so. So you won't be able to skip that many songs, and it's more like a radio thing. So if you know what genre you want to hear but not exactly sure which type of music you want, or you just want to be skipping to next song yourself, this will keep playing one song after the other. And of course you can skip them, like I said, up to 5 or 6 times. Now that's for this right here, which is SongSound app. Now you have a bunch of genres. You can even go to your recent, okay, and you can see which ones you hear the most. Okay, they're like radio stations, let's call them. They're not really, they're more like playlists already made for you. They come up with the newest type of music that they can find, and that's it. You can also share some stuff, and you can also go to decades, for example. And that's pretty neat for those of you who are looking for something a little bit older, maybe. So here you can go for something newer, older, whichever. Okay, so let's say you guys want something simple, this is it for you. Now if you guys want something more complicated, a little bit more complicated, that only has one commercial every 30 minutes, this would be it. Okay, Spotify, as you will see, I'm gonna browse. Now the setup is easy. I don't have a separate video to show you the setup, but it's just putting your email next, except and all the things that come up. Now you will see commercials here. Sometimes it'll take a little bit to load up if you guys get a lot of commercials. Now let's go into radio so you guys can see that. We're not just gonna load all of them right now. And you can also see your music settings. Okay, radio right here. So you can pick from a bunch of stations. So I know a lot of people like Spotify because of this, because you can pick these type of things. So let's go into country again, just for an example. The loading times does matter mostly on your Wi-Fi or 3G network, how long that'll take. You can cruise around some radio stations. Now if you go back into browse, or let's go into search. Now if you search for Sean Paul, for example, you want a song from him, a specific song, you will not be able to play it from this app, okay? It's gonna shuffle play all the songs. Okay, that's in the free version, so you're gonna have to shuffle all these songs. So you kinda have to wait till you get to a song that you want to hear. Now it's pretty easy to handle, as you can see. But yeah, that's it for this app. I'm not gonna go through it more, just because it's pretty simple to handle, and it's there's no playlist or anything like that. Now that's why I put these two at the bottom of my list. They're not the best ones for me. For me, if I want a specific song and I want to make a playlist, I want iMusic Plus or I want Musify. So those two are great for making playlists and putting exactly what song you want to hear. So let's go into Musify. Well, actually, let's just go into this one, because they kind of look the same, and a lot of the whole inside of it, and even the top 100 songs, everything's pretty much the same in these two. So you can choose either Musify or the other one, they're both free anyways, and you will get pretty much the same options. So let's say you guys want to look for Sean Paul or Michelle Montana, let's say we want this specific song, you can't get the specific song. Now the bad thing about this, once you get it and you play it, you guys are gonna just hear the song and then it's not gonna go to the next one. It's gonna go to the next one over here, which is other remixes and just other type of, it's the same song but just different remixes that they've made. So that can be good and bad. Like I said, it won't go to the next song, let's say that's something similar to the song, so you have to manually go and look for another song that you want to put. However, if you guys want to make a playlist, then it's gonna go to the next one that you put on your playlist. So for example, this one, I'm just gonna choose this one. I'm gonna put add to playlist. I already created a playlist, so this one called Soca. So I'm gonna add that one on. I'm gonna put done. then let's say I'm gonna add this one on as well. There's the plus sign on the right side, you guys can see. All you have to do is tap on that, then tap on done, and that's it. Then I can go to my playlist, go into Soca. I have those four songs. I can play the first one, and then it's gonna go to the second one, and so on. So then I can just turn off my screen and enjoy the music. And once it's done, then I can go to another playlist that I created, and so on. So that's good for playlists, and if you know specifically what type of song you want to hear. Okay, so those are my top two, that you can be a little more specific what type of songs you want. Then my other two, Spotify and SongStud, those are the bottom, just because they're a little bit more like radio stations. And then we go into PlayTube. Now PlayTube, it's nice because they're videos. So I know a lot of you, if you're watching YouTube, for example, and you're putting on a video, it's not, but there we go. Okay, so if you're putting on a video, let's say I look for this, and you just shut down your screen on your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch, you're gonna see that it stops the video and stops the music. With this, you can turn off your screen and it's gonna continue the music. So that's the cool thing about this, and I know that's why a lot of you like PlayTube, just because you can do that. Now, in PlayTube, you can also make playlists, which makes it convenient, just to go to the next song and so on. The whatever playlist you make, for example, my first one right here says Latino 2. I just added these two onto it, and there's these other ones down here that have already been created. Now that's the cool thing about also about this app. I'm just gonna put on a video so you guys kind of get a glance at it. They don't take that long in loading up. Okay, that's it. That's all I'm gonna put from this one. You guys don't really need to see more. They're excellent quality. It is kind of to replace YouTube, because YouTube will pretty much stop your playing once you turn off your screen. And here you can make playlists, so that's pretty convenient. However, I do want to mention that there are some apps out there that will let you play YouTube videos on the background, so you can turn off your screen and those videos will keep playing so you can hear music. But that's another video, another day. These are my top 5 music apps. So number 1 would be PlayTube, just because they're videos, and at the same time, you can make your playlist and you can hear the MP3s on the background, okay? I just wanna mention one that I didn't put on my top 5, that's called One Turner. Now this one is a radio, okay? So I'm gonna open it up. So One Turner, this is just radios around the world. So if you guys want to hear a radio that you heard maybe when you went to France or Jamaica or something like that, if you know one, you can just search for it. So let's say, or if you know the genre that you want to hear something more authentic and something that's playing at that country. So for example, reggae. And you can also specify what countries you want. I'm not going to get into that just yet. I just want to show you guys this as my extra app. Just for those of you who like radio, the quality, the audio quality from this one is not as good as the other ones, okay? Because the other ones are just online. These are online radio, and radio signals are not always the best. So that's why it's not going to be as clear as the other ones, but it's still pretty good. So for example, here you have USA, Poland, Germany, France, UK, and a bunch of other ones. So you will not see all the countries here. And this app, I just want to mention it last, just because it's a paid one, I think. I'm not sure if it's a free version for it, but I know it's paid. You guys might find it for free, so check that out. And once again, this is just radio. You don't pick the artist or you don't search for the song. You actually search for the genre or the radio station that you guys heard in maybe another country. And that's the main reason why people actually download this app itself. Anyways, I just want to give a shout out for that app. And there's another one, it's called Radio. I'm not gonna open that one just because it's not that good. But it exists, and I just want to show you guys that one. And if you guys want to download music onto your phone and you guys don't want to stream music like all these apps do, and you just want to hear it whenever you don't have any Wi-Fi signal or any 3G, then there's no app that does that exactly. The way that we do that is that we download an app that can download stuff, such as PDF files or anything, such as this iDownloaded app that I have right here. And from there, we can just go to a web page and download the music from there. Once it's downloaded, it's kept on your phone and you can hear it anytime for free. Okay, other than that, you have to pay for it if you go to iTunes and download music. This is the free way of doing it, but that's another video. Just making sure to subscribe if you guys want to see that. You can also, for example, if you have an iPad and an iPhone and you want to be DJ, for example, you want to stream that music from your phone to your iPad, there's another way of doing that as well. So you can download this app right here, that's called Cedio, and from here you can play any music that's on your phone and you will hear it on your iPad. Both iDevices will need the same app, okay, and that's how you can hear one to the other. So you're kind of streaming your music from one iDevice to the other using this. So it's good if you're in a party, you plug it into your radio or your speakers, and you just want to DJ from your phone to your iPad or vice versa, it doesn't really matter. You can do that with this app. So I just want to mention those. Anyways, that's it for this video tutorial. If you guys have any comments, questions, you can write them here below in the comments area. And don't forget to subscribe and rate. Thank you.